My name is Paul Nielsen. I collect music memorabilia, specifically from the Beatles and Kiss, and Doctor Who merchandise. And I've brought in some various Kiss merchandise today and my collection of Daleks. I've been collecting music memorabilia and Doctor Who merchandise since around about 1979 when I was a young boy, growing up with music all around me. And specifically when Kiss hit the big time in 1979, I was watching Countdown on TV and other music shows, got caught up in all the Kisteria, as it was coined at the time, and of course watching Doctor Who ever since a little boy as well. Suddenly the merchandising hit big time with Kiss especially, and from an early age I realised that unique one-of-a-kind items were good to collect and to save for the future. The first item I would have collected would have been the Viewmaster Reel series, and they released a Kiss version or a Kiss edition. I still have that to this day, and combined, I guess, with Kiss and Doctor Who, I'd probably have close to 2,000 items in my collection. I keep most of my Kiss collection in dust-free boxes, as it is getting very old, and a lot of it is very rare and very highly sought these days, especially the early stuff from the 70s, so I like to keep that in good condition out of the dust. My Doctor Who or my Daleks are on display in a glass cabinet. I generally buy items when they are released at the time. I'm not a big fan of trying to hunt things down on eBay or auctions. I like to buy them as they come out at the time. Even my early stuff I obtained back in the late 70s and the very early 80s, and I've kept ever since. So what we have on display here are some of the rarer Kiss items that are really hard to find. A set of three Kiss dolls that were released in 1978. Not that I played with dolls when I was a kid, but I was given one of these dolls at the time, and the other two I have obtained since. So they're very rare, and they fetch a lot of money on eBay, etc. these days, so I'm hanging on to those ones. I have two jigsaw puzzles that were released in 1978. They are very hard to find as well. I've brought them in. A promotional disc that used to hang up in the record shops back in 1980 for the Kiss album Unmasked. I pestered the shopkeeper lady that many times that she eventually gave it to me when I was in grade three. And one of my newer collections is you can now purchase deluxe full-sized costumes released by the band. And I have some of the boots here on display today from 1975. Favourite items from my collections, and again we're talking two collections here, obviously from Doctor Who I have a full-sized operable working Dalek based on the 1975 episode. I was specially built here in Townsville based on the original specifications from the BBC right down to the paintwork. From my Kiss collection, I guess one item that is very important to me is a tape recording of an interview that I did with the drummer from Kiss, Eric Carr, in 1990 when I spoke to him on the phone from a local radio station here. I have the master copy of that in my little collection, and unfortunately Eric Carr passed away the year later, so it's very special in my collection, that one. My friends and family often marvel at my collections when I do bring them out occasionally and show them, and of course the full-size Dalek is a big conversation piece, especially when the pest control people come around and they are taken unaware of it. And I guess the Kiss stuff, of course, I have a lot of musical friends and they like to see a lot of that musical memorabilia, and it's quite amazing to seeing so many old pieces in my collection. And having said that, I can't imagine a time when Kiss merchandise will ever stop. They seem to be a band that keeps churning it out every year after year for new generations of Kiss fans. And a lot of the stuff, because of its value, I will generally keep it forever. And maybe one day they'll be in the museum as a permanent display. Doctor Who did start back in 1963 in the black and white era of television. And I guess having watched all the repeats on the ABC, John Pertwee would be my favourite Doctor Who. He played the Doctor from 1970 to 1974, transitioning into Tom Baker, who is a big favourite for most fans. But personally myself, I think John Pertwee was an excellent Doctor. Here we have a collection of the Dalek models that I've collected over the years, ranging from early 80s to up until 2012 these models were released. Two of the bigger Daleks are remote controlled Daleks, so the kids have a lot of fun with those. One of these Daleks that I've made myself through a kit, and the rest are official BBC merchandise that you buy as is. Growing up in the 80s, I was very fortunate to travel a lot of Australia with my family, And of course, during those days in the 80s, the internet never existed, so shops were aplenty down in those sort of, you know, Sydney and Melbourne and Brisbane. I really enjoy that aspect of collecting and finding something new all the time. And I hope, and it's given me a chance to actually display some of my rare items that most people generally won't see in the live flesh, so to speak. And I hope everybody really enjoys what I've brought on display here today.